That shot, but they're so fearful of Indiana's inside strength that they may back inside and let that outside shot become available to them.
Yeah, I think as you commented on earlier, they're aware of Fox inside, and they want to try to keep things from happening to him. That was an excellent drive by Sutton then. That's two times he's penetrated, going all the way to basket, and without any inside help.
John Sutton converts the three-point play. It was back up to Pelphrey. He was one out of two from the free throw stripe. Did not get them both. So it's a 11-4 ball game. Now, Indiana trailed in that ball game at Market Square last Saturday, but they never got themselves any kind of real serious problem. Here is the tip and the steal. Now a 2-on-1 break. Here comes Porter, and he slams it. Desmond Porter's got his first two, and George Griffith has had all he wants. He wants to get a little talk time to his ball club. It's 13-4 Kentucky. You're watching the Indiana-Kentucky All-Star basketball game. The Indiana All-Star trails 13-4. Edwards firing and missing, and perhaps, yeah, it was basket interference that time. Edwards will get credit for the hoop. Jay's first 2 points of the ballgame. What did George Griffith have to say to you, anticipate, as we look at the replay again, Bill Harrell?
Well, the thing that's happening now is they are playing Edwards tight outside, and he penetrated with the ball that time, took it to basket. At this point in time, they're going to have to penetrate because the defense is tight.
Good play by Pelphrey underneath. He got around the defensive man, got the reverse layup for his first field goal. He has 3 points in this contest. 15:55 to play, first half, playing college 20-minute halves. We'll talk about the other rules in a moment. That's Edwards' second bucket. We are playing the 45-second shot clock, bonus in effect with the seventh foul of the half. Player fouls out in five timeouts, and they've got the three-point field goal shot, and that's right at the top of the free throw circle. It measures 19-9 to the center of the hoop. And, Bill, a lot of coaches in the high school ranks this year are going to use that as a weapon. Some aren't going to like it, but some are going to be able to use it.
Yeah, I tell you, it's going to make a lot of difference in the ball games. You get down, a lot of people are going to be shooting.
Here is the steal. Sean Sutton, this is to Pelphrey. Pelphrey tried to left-hand it up there, and it didn't hit anything with the backboard. Here is Jay Edwards. He had it deflected away on a personal foul. The foul is on Lamont Ware. There is a feeling in Kentucky that that young man, Lamont Ware, number 6, maybe should have been wearing number 1 as Mr. Basketball.
I think he did an excellent job in the game last week. His stats were really great. 8 for 12 from the field, 4 for 5 from the free throw line, had 11 rebounds, just had a fantastic game.
Talking about last week, Bill, it's interesting to note that in that Kentucky game up at Market Square Arena, as Edwards hits the first free throw shot, and he has 5 points. In the three-point area, Kentucky took 27 three-pointers, Indiana only 5. Do we not have the outside shooters, or was the game just so much in the favor of Indiana they didn't have to go outside?
Well, the thing that happened last week was Kentucky was playing tough outside, and they didn't think Fox was as good a player, and so Indiana went inside all night to Fox, and that's why he got the 24 points.
Sutton missing and tipped out of bounds by Kentucky Indiana basketball.
You'll notice tonight, Fox isn't getting the ball inside. Feldhaus is fronting him, and they're playing the ball tough outside. It makes it tough to get any ball movement, get synchronization from the players to run a pattern.
So a 9-point lead has been chopped down to 5 at 15-10 with 14:45 to play. Edwards long on the shot. And off the mark was Harmon on the rebound. He was actually mistimed the leap. He would have had a slam jam there. Kentucky back with the basketball and a 5-point lead. They try to play backdoor. They do. And deflected away that time by Indiana. By it's Keyes who gets the layup. Misses. Rebound Kentucky. It's been a tough couple of weeks for both these ball clubs. They went to camp, of course, the week before that game last Saturday. And they've had nothing but basketball, Bill Harrell, shoved down their throat for the last couple of weeks. They're anxious to get this thing over with, play well, of course, and win, and then head on down the pike somewhere.
Yeah, I think you'll notice the benches will come into play very soon because in the summertime, you can't go quite as long as you can in the regular season. And I think that's going to have some bearing on the game tonight because Kentucky really appears ready to play.
Excellent inbounds play, and Feldhaus now has 5 points, a three-pointer and a two-pointer, and the lead goes back to 7 at 17-10. This series going back a number of years. We're going to talk with the game director, Don Bates, also talk with Jim Pulaski of the Star at halftime about the proceeds in this event. And we're also going to, as the foul is called on number 10, Derry Keys of Indiana. We're going to have a chance to talk with Cinda Brown and hopefully Lori Minerding and maybe one of the other girls with their win tonight.
Fox did a good job on the board that time, but you notice number 10 came over the back and made the foul, so Kentucky got the ball. But Indiana did hit the boards real hard that time.
We'll see if George Griffith goes to the All-Marion lineup. He did last week in the first half of the ballgame. Had all five of the Marion players in the lineup at one time. Lamont Ware posting down low. Now, he's not a particularly big guy, but he does a good job muscling inside. Ware is only 6'3", a 185-pounder. 19-10, back to the nine-point lead, the biggest of the ballgame for Kentucky. Indiana has yet to lead. Good play inside by Rick Fox. Fox second bucket and a foul call. The basket's going to count. The indications are it'll be on Darren Foulhouse. Bill?
You'll notice that Edwards is being guarded by Pelphrey, who is 6'7", and is making it tough for Edwards to get his outside shot. That's why he's penetrated with the ball tonight instead of shooting from the outside. So I think Pelphrey just left the lineup, and it'll be interesting to see how they play Edwards now, because I think Edwards is going to be a key figure in the game because he isn't a great player, an excellent outside shooter.
I tell you what, if I was going to mold a basketball player, I think I'd use Rick Fox as my design. Because, boy, he just looks like the kind of a kid that can play this game.
He's a great player.
Rick Fox playing for Al Rhodes up at Warsaw, averaged 21-1 2 years ago. He didn't play this past year, as we talked about. There's a nice move by Donald Timmis. Both coaches, as Bill Harrell suggested, have gone to the bench now. We're seeing some changes in that lineup. We're going to see them throughout the game. Not that it's exceedingly hot today, because it's not been kind of a cool day, but because of the wear and tear for the last couple of weeks. Indiana missing some shots in the paint area. Super defensive play initially by Jerry Coleman. Rebounded by Ellery, and a whistle and a foul. My goodness. Coleman starts the whole thing off by just deflecting the ball away, and we'll pick it up here and see what happens.
Well, you'll notice underneath that Kentucky got off two or three shots with Ellery, who will be doing his play at Notre Dame next year, really going strong to the board and getting fouled and shooting the free throws.
This is Kevin. Somebody suggested Kevin might be going to Notre Dame on a football scholarship. Well, we could sell him by the pound. We could make some money, Coach.
He's a great one.
Kevin Ellery, averaged 29-7 and 8.9 rebounds during this past year at Washington County High School. 82% free throw shooter. He is 2 out of 2 tonight. Kentucky from that free throw stripe now, 4 out of 5. And the biggest lead of the ballgame goes to 10. The Hoosiers have yet to lead. They got down in a hurry in this ball game with some ragged play in the first minute or so. Here is Fox. Fox now is the high point gunner for the Hoosiers. He has 7 points. 23-15, 12:05 to play here in this first half, and Coleman gets caught for a foul. You saw a little bit of Jerry Coleman this past year, didn't you, in the conference?
Jerry did a great job in the conference, and of course, he's partially responsible for the great season George Griffith had at Richmond this year. Being runners-up for the state championship this year, Richmond just had a great year, and of course, George did a great job. Players and put Ware on Edwards now. Of course, Ware is much quicker than Pelphrey, and he's really playing Edwards tight.
Ellery lost the basketball. It's 3-on-2 now. Edwards takes it in and scores. Well, just as we talk about Edwards being shut off for the last minute or so, he comes up with his 8th point of the ball game. He's the high point man. He has 8. Fox has 7. Lyndon Jones has the other 2 points. Nobody else in the white uniforms has scored so far. And Indiana wearing the white because they wore them. The team that wears the home uniforms for the first game back at Indiana last week wears them this week. It's simply a matter of economics.
Indiana has changed defenses. They're in a matchup defense now. Like the Bill Green matchup, and they did an excellent job that time shifting and got out on the break.
Coleman doing a good job penetrating. Nobody picked him up at the free throw line, and Jerry's got his first 2. Speaking of Bill Green, he is here tonight, so I'm on the way in, and of course he was supposed to coach this All-Star squad this year and then took the job at the University of Indianapolis, and George Griffith, who was the runner-up to him again this year for the state title, took over the job. He and Larry Angle have done a good job, and it's a tough job.
And coaching All-Stars is never an easy job.
And you had it twice. You lost 2-1 here.
Yeah, I thought they'd never let me coach again after that.
But they brought you back and you won 2 the next time around. That was in 83.
The players you have do have a difference, make a difference.
Good steal by Jay Edwards, and Edwards now with 10. Your Mr. Basketball in 83 wasn't bad.
No, it is. Steve Alford's a great player.
Indiana's chopped the lead from 10 down to 2, 23-21. They've turned it around in a hurry. Now knocked away inside. Edwards is fouled, and Ellery got him. And that's the first on Kevin Ellery. You'd almost feel this ball game, the momentum starting to change sides, Coach.
Well, the thing that's happening is Kentucky's not getting any shots against the defense. And as you see there, Edwards stole the ball again. And that made the difference. The change in the defenses has caused quite a turnaround.
Time out. You're watching the Indiana-Kentucky All-Star Basketball. Since Indiana has trailed throughout most of this ball game, Bill Harrell, is that statistic right there?
Yeah, Kentucky's out-rebounded Indiana tonight, 13-7. And I think that the game's turned around a little bit now, but Kentucky has changed defenses, going to a half-court trap. And I think it was necessary for them to do something because they definitely have lost the tempo of the game.
Edwards got another field goal. Credit the assist to Coleman. And Edwards, on a second effort, got the tip. And after missing the first one, here's the three-pointer. He had it out of there. Rebounded by Ellery. Ellery had it knocked away. Now we got a tie ball game. This is the first time this ball game has been tied. It's tied at 23. Indiana trailed by as many as 10 about 2 or 3 minutes ago. I made a good, strong run. So maybe the defensive changes that Kentucky made came back to haunt him at the other end of the floor.
They don't want to run with Indiana. If they do, I think Indiana will win handily. But Indiana has played the pressure defense after a made basket, and this made a difference as well.
Donald Tibbs at one of the guard spots with a couple of points. He has the basketball. Now Darren Feldhaus back to Tibbs, off of the near wing to Prince Stewart. And they leave Stewart alone. He doesn't take the shot, though. They dish it off inside now to Matthew Itudis, and he's got his first 2 points of the ball game. Well, Kentucky's getting its scoring spread out amongst their 11-man roster. And they lead again by a couple of points, 25-23, but not anymore. Because Jerome Harmon gets his first 2 points of the contest and tie ball game at 25. The pace has begun to quicken a little bit. And I would suspect that when Marvin Meredith of Russell High School begins to realize that, he's liable to try to want to slow things down again. Nice alley-oop play to Lamont Ware.
One of the reasons for the quickness change was the insertion of... No, I know him as well as I know anybody.
he's not on the roster.
The little guy from Richmond, Coleman.
Here's the alley-oop play again, Bill. Yeah,
they cleared everything out and made the alley-oop play across the basket. Ware went up and put it in. He's really a great player. I think he was injured this year and only played in 10 games. And that's the reason we hadn't heard as much about him.
Substitution to the lineup now for Indiana. Brett Etherington will come into the ball game. Becky's in there and just got his first 2 points of the contest. That'll make Joe Sexton smile. That's where Etherington is headed next year to play with the Butler University Bulldogs. Here is Pelphrey. Pelphrey got it on a good, strong baseline move. John has already had a better ball game tonight than he had last Saturday night. He had only 3 points. He's 5 so far in this ball game. A couple of field goals and 1 out of 2 from the charity stripe. And the lead goes back to 2 again, 29-27. Coleman makes things happen, boy.
Great pass.
He did that so well in the regional last year. It was unbelievable. And the semis too. He just simply made things happen. The three outside is good by Prince Stewart. Stewart, a 16-7 score over the season haul for the folks at Lexington Lafayette, as his first three of the night. Here's the reach-in foul by Pelphrey, number one on him. With 8:11 to go in the first half, it's 32-29. Kentucky's going back in front after being tied at 25.
Now, they've gone to a 2-2-1 full-court press, and that's caused the game to speed up as well. And Kentucky does have some good speed and quickness. And as I mentioned, Ware, a great player from Hopkinsville, and Prince Stewart from Lexington Lafayette really have good speed and quickness.
Indiana trailing now by 32-29. They were down by 10 early in this contest. Finally caught up at 23, tied at 25, and now 32-29 with 8 minutes to play in the half. and a foul, and it's on Desmond Porter. Bill, you talk about speed and quickness. Did we see some of that in the first game tonight with the girls?
Oh, Dana Wilkerson, she just took over in both games, the latter part of the game, and just blew by everyone. Just a great game she had tonight. And our girls' teams certainly are to be commended because they did a great job in both games.
Indiana had only one sweep. That was back in 84, and they swept both ball games by winning 88-73 tonight. And that was a game that, with about 2 minutes to go, was only about a 5 or 6 point difference.
Yeah, and Dana Wilkerson took over against the full court pressure and scored about three baskets, and the game's over.
Good, strong muscle move inside, and the foul is called. That is Sam Howard. Sam Howard getting his first 2 points. The foul is on Matthew Itoudis, number one on him.
Now that was a great play by Sam Howard. Then he made the pivot inside, went up strong, shot the good soft shot, and put it in the basket. You'll notice that Indiana's gone to its bench and have five new players in the lineup. They're only down 1 point. This was 7:54 to go. Now it's time.
Sam Howard played for Randy Snodgrass at Manchester High School and averaged 19.5 points a ball game. Indiana's now 4 out of 4 from the stripe. We're tied for the third time in the first half, this time at 32. Here is the steal. Fine feed. Here's the layup. Indiana goes ahead for the first time. The hoop by Dave Barrett and the steal on the inbounds pass by Barrett. Etherington can't get it. Rebounded by Kentucky. Indiana played up to the 7.5-minute mark before they finally took the lead. They're out in front, 34-32. Good baseline move and a good dish back outside to Desmond Porter for his second bucket. Now the pace is really quickened, Coach.
Well, Indiana has five new players in the lineup, and they're playing excellently and have passed the ball well. Barrett just has done a tremendous job handling the basketball. It was a great pass he made cross court, and we missed the bucket, but Indiana is playing real well right now with the new lineup in the game to give the starters rest, and I think this is going to have a great bearing on the game because I think the next time the starters come back in, they'll have a feel for the game, and they see what's going on. They know they're in a ball game, and they're really going to have to play to win the basketball game.
There is an excitement, is there not, Bill, when you're in an all-star game. It's being televised. You've got a good crowd on hand. These guys are all-stars. They're the veterans of their squad, but there's still an excitement factor that's built in, and there's no way in the world you can stop the juices from flowing under the pressure that they're under right now.
That's exactly right. Everybody's up for the game, and they're all real happy to be here, and they know they're representing their state. They're the best basketball players in the state, chosen to be that, and it's quite an honor, and that's why it's such a thrill to be in an event such as this.
Pelphrey knocks them both home. And he is now 3 out of 4 from the charity stripe, 7 points for John. And with 7 minutes to go in the first half of this basketball game, Indiana's down by 2 again. But they have been behind much of this ball game. It wasn't until about the 7.5-minute mark they finally caught up and took the lead. John Wilczynski is in the ball game, number 12 out of Merrillville, played for Jim East, heading for the University of Akron. Dropped it down inside to Sam Howard. Howard had it knocked away, but last touch by Kentucky. Prince Stewart has some pretty good speed on that guy's body, too.
Got the ball inside to Sam Howard. Prince Stewart dropped back in from his guard position, blocked the shot. Prince Stewart's only 5'10", Sam Howard 6'8".
Yeah, a baseline violation on the inbounds pass. And Kentucky will get it. Now Barrett is talking to the official, and he's going to lose that battle. Now some pressure. Jimmy Apple's in the ball game for Indiana, number 2. Now they quickly drop back and let him set up the half-court offense. 6:36 to play. You're not hearing a lot of noise because of Kentucky's lead. It's because, I swear to goodness, at least three-fourths of the crowd here tonight's got to be from Indiana. That is Stewart's second three-pointer in this ball game. So a half a dozen points for Prince, who averaged 16.7 this past year, playing for Lexington Lafayette, headed for UTEP, University of Texas at El Paso. Apple to Etherington, lost it. Dishes off near side to Wilczynski. Good, strong baseline move. Howard's got it now. He lost it. And out they come again. This is Prince Stewart leading the break, but a two-on-two, no advantage. Stewart kind of threw it up for grabs and a walking violation call. That speed is great, Bill, but can also get you in trouble sometimes.
You have to stay under control. Prince Stewart made a good move to the basket then. Excellent defense by Etherington. Blocked the shot. And Indiana got the ball.
5 minutes and 50 seconds to play in the first half of this ball game. Hoosiers down by five, 39-34, and we got five Indiana players getting set to come back into the lineup, and that's pretty much what Bill Harrell suggested might happen. Let them sit down for a while. Let them get the lay of the land. See what's going on out there, and then put your starting unit back in. Here is a foul called against number 10, Joey Couch, for Kentucky. Now, here comes the change of the lineup you suggested might be going to happen, Bill.
Well, I think you'll find that the intensity will really pick up. I think the starters played well early, but I think it always helps to get them out for a little while. And but I thought that the five subs that came in did an excellent job while they were in there.
Yes. Now, Fox will not come in because he will replace Howard, who is going to be at the free throw line. Sam is one out of one from there. There's a look at the Indiana bench. Boy, George Griffith has done a great job at Richmond High School, and Larry Angle, who is now at Tipton a few years back, had Rushville into that state championship game. So those guys have tasted the pressure of what it's like, as have you, to get in that kind of a situation.
Larry Angle does a great job coaching. He was an assistant to me in 83 and invaluable to us. And, of course, as I've said, George is one of the premier coaches in the state of Indiana.
Now here is Howard looking for his third successive free throw, and he's got it. So Sam now with 5 points. Now we'll get that substitution change. Fox will come in, and Howard will go out. There is Fox, Rick Fox. He has 7 points, got those early in this contest. And there's your half, there's your score as we head toward the 5.5 minute mark of the first half. Last tie was at 34. Here is Pelphrey, may have touched the baseline. Indeed, he did.
You notice Indiana came right back with a 2-2-1 full court press. They're fresh. They want to increase the tempo. And 5:27 to go, down by three. I think they're really going to go strong in movement of the basketball and on defense.
And thinking back to last week, I believe the score was tied at halftime, was it not?
Yeah, I think that's correct.
Yeah, 44-44 at halftime last week at Market Square Arena. Here's the alley-oop. Harmon couldn't get it. Fox goes to chase it down. 5:10 to go, all by himself is Edwards. A little bit of a showboat, perhaps, on the part of Jerome Harmon that time. And it did kind of liven up the crowd. Here is Fox on the near steal, and Fox on the personal foul. And on Rick, number two.
A foul is on Rick Fox, number seven, his second in the game for Kentucky.
You know, had the pass after the lob was missed, the rebound, the pass to Edwards underneath for the slam dunk.
Now more changes for Kentucky. They have Sean Sutton in the lineup. Desmond Porter is in there. John Pelphrey is in the lineup. Lamont Ware likewise in the ballgame. And Darren Feldhaus. Feldhaus was the top scorer in last week's ballgame for the Kentucky All-Stars with 23 points and 8 rebounds. And Pelphrey now with 8 points. Now another change for the Hoosier All-Star squad.
Number 7.
Fox will go out after a very short stay, and Derek Keyes will come back into the ballgame.
I don't know how many fouls he has on him, but I think it has something to do with it.
Well, that would have got Fox for two. Yeah. Pelphrey missing. 2-point lead for Kentucky. Here is Harmon trying to tie, and does.
Most coaches don't want to let a star player like Fox get three on them in the first half. They'd rather, even if they're behind, they'd rather go in with only two fouls on a player of his caliber than three, because the other coach will try to get to him early in the second half and make him pick up that fourth foul.
Well, I'll tell you, right there's a kid that can shoot you into or out of a ball game in a hurry. Sean Sutton, his first three-pointer of this contest. He has 10 points in the ball game so far. Derek Keyes, here is Coleman. Boy, he is tough from that area right there. Jerry Coleman's second field goal. 17-9 score for the Red Devils of Richmond High School. Pelphrey makes a save deep in that corner. 43-42 now with Kentucky out in front with 4 minutes and 3 seconds to go in the first half. Good rebound and a fine follow-up by Desmond Porter. The ball actually came out and almost hit Porter. He was going in for the rebound, and the thing almost got over his head. Back to a three-point lead now. Here is Jay Edwards of Marion. Edwards, little 14-footer inside. Follows it, can't get it. Rebounded by Jones. He can't get it. Rebounded by Edwards, and he lost it, but a foul is called. Where do you see, not to put you on the spot, Bill, where do you see Edwards and Jones playing at IU when they finally join the squad? If you take a look at the replay again, are we looking at guards or forwards here?
Well, I think Jones would play a point guard, and Edwards will play a wingman, a shooter, much as Steve Alford was used.
Yeah, it's going to be fun for the IU fans to watch those guys. And, of course, you look down the All-Star roster, and they're, for the most part, heading to various schools in and out of the state. And this looks to me like one of the best All-Star rosters we've had in some time.
I think that's true. You have people going to Louisville, IU, and North Carolina. That's pretty tough.
Darren Feldhaus with his first foul. Edwards missing the second of two. Jay's had himself a pretty good first half. Got a half a dozen field goals and two out of three from the stripe for 14. Out of the 3:35 mark in the first half. Pelphrey on the baseline, left side. There was a lot of criticism for naming Pelphrey Mr. Basketball and then the way he performed last week, so I'm sure he has something to prove, and I'm sure the coaches would like for him to prove that and prove right those persons who named John Pelphrey Mr. Basketball. He had a good Kentucky career with averaging 20.2, and there's the outside shot by Edwards. Edwards' first three-pointer of the ball game, Bill.
If Pelphrey plays well, as I said before the game, that'll make it a much tougher ball game for Indiana, and he is playing well tonight.
Feldhaus. So just like Indiana gets a couple of hard-earned points, the three hard-earned points, Kentucky comes back up court and sets up in a hurry and gets two of them right back. 2:45 to play. Coleman penetrates, dishes it back outside, but caught for the charging foul. Second foul on Jerry. And a timeout, I believe. Let's see. Now, maybe that. We'll take the replay again here.
Coleman penetrated with the ball, made a good penetration, but left his feet too quick and charged.
All right, the Indianapolis Star presents the World Series of High School Basketball, the Indiana-Kentucky All-Star Game. Last time we saw that stat, 18-12, Kentucky still owns the boards.
Yeah, I think that's going to have to improve some because Indiana needs to get in a running game if possible.
And the turnovers?
Indiana's handled the ball real well, and Kentucky only has six.
I was a little surprised last week, Bill, in that ball game. Kentucky kicked it away 18 times, Indiana 14. That's not bad for an All-Star game.
No, especially when you're playing with different people that you haven't played with.
All right, the Hoosiers trail by 3, 49-46. They trail by 10 about a fourth of the way into this first half. They finally caught up and tied the ball game at 23. It's been tied five times, but now they are down by 3, 49-46, with 2.5 minutes to go here in the first half.
Well, you notice that Indiana has the Marion lineup in there doing a good job with the matchup defense, but I think for a couple of minutes in both games, you see the five players from Marion on the court.
Yeah, that's where they are right now. Here's the foul being called inside against Kentucky. It'll be on number six. That is Lamont Weir. We're going to talk at halftime with Don Bates, who is the game director, and we're going to talk about, this is the first time this has ever happened, five kids in the same school, and one of the things we're going to talk about is they increased the roster to allow that to happen so that nobody else got shoved off that roster, but that's what it is now. This is the unit that won three successive state championships, and that deserves some kind of an honor.
It deserves some recognition, and I think it's great that everybody understands it. No one was left off the All-Star team, so the other two players would come on. Had they not come on the All-Star team, Indiana would have had 11 players.
Exactly, which is what Kentucky has, 11 men on their roster, so there was an adjustment made on the part of Kentucky, part of Indiana, to allow that to happen, but not to take anybody else off of it. There is the outside shot again. Feldhaus with his second three-pointer in this ball game. Bill, we're going to have to go out and pick him up.
I'll tell you, Feldhaus is a great shooter, and Kentucky's really ready to play.
Here's the tip. Jones has got it. He is fouled by number 11, Kevin Ellery. Maybe Kentucky came to play a little more than we did tonight.
Yeah, it always makes a difference when you're playing at home.
And after you've won the first ball game, that's what we touched on in our opening stand-up, do you have to go back to the to Indiana Central, University of Indianapolis now, and convince the kids they ain't not as good as they thought they were?
Well, you better convince them because the mental attitude in the All-Star game is half the game. And I think we're seeing that tonight. I think Indiana is playing hard. Kentucky seems to be determined at this time.
I've got Jones only for his third point of the contest. Misses the second. The rebound is tipped free, and Jones goes to get it. Indiana could use a couple of quick hoops here. They're down 54-48. We're approaching halftime. It's a minute and 35 away. Yeah, here's Edwards. Forced the shot, rebounded by Ure, and I think he shoved off. So it's Edwards and Jones and Ure. And will you take a look at it again? Persinger is in there.
I think Edwards made a great penetration that time, and he was guarded very closely. It looked like he might have gotten nipped on the arm, but he had a good shot.
And Derry Keyes rounds out that Marion 5. Indiana and Kentucky, who since they added the girls' game a few years back, have never won all four games. Now the girls have done their job. Now the pressure was on the guys. Kevin Ellery with 3 points on 3 out of 3 from the charity stripe. Now four. And the lead goes back to 8 points again. Now, the biggest lead of the ball game was 10 by Kentucky. Indiana has led only a couple of times and never by more than 2 points. Nice move by Keyes. Follow away shots of beauty. Keyes getting his first 2 points of the contest. Number 10 out of Marion, heading for Wake Forest. Last week in the All-Star game, 6 points on 3 out of 7 shooting and 5 rebounds. A minute 5 to play in the first half.
Now, I think Kentucky's got their best lineup in the ball game right now. And they're really playing well together, and I think that's going to be a goal team.
We're going to get the goal team. Take a look at it again here, Bill. He never touched the ball. He touched the bottom of the net, I believe.
Desmond Porter shot me outside, an official rule that goaltending.
Well, if he didn't get it, it was close anyway, and that's the basket interference situation that gives the three-pointer. Here's the foul inside as Keyes turned to the hoop, and the foul is on Kentucky. And I believe it's on Porter. Yeah, that's his third personal foul. I guess that's something new we'll have to start thinking about with high school basketball, the goal 10 or interference on a three-point shot now.
Yeah, that was a big play.
He kicked the lead back to 9 again. And Keyes has 3. And Indiana's going to go to the locker room at halftime, trailing. And I would imagine that Mr. Griffith, Mr. Ang will have some words of encouragement for the ball club in the second half because they have not played very inspired basketball.
Yeah, I think that's true.
Final 27 seconds of the first half. Porter has had himself a pretty good first half of play. He's got 11 points. They've all come from the field. And a foul on Lamont Ware, number 3.
Now you'll notice that Kentucky's moved their pressure out again and double-teamed the ball outside to keep Indiana from running the set pattern. And they fouled that time, but they did increase the tempo of the game, and you see that they've run up a 12-point margin.
Lyndon Jones over the season at Marion averaged right at 20 points a game, 19-9. So far tonight he has but 3 points. Last week he scored 16 points and pulled down 5 boards in that victory. Now we're down to the final 13 seconds of the first half, and Indiana's trailing by a 61-53 margin. Kicked away, belongs to Indiana. So the Hoosiers have been outscored 21-13 since the ball game was tied at 40. 4 seconds to go, 3, Jones shooting, missing. Well, that's the end of the first half. Well, it's been a tough one.
We have to get over in front of him. We have to keep him from penetrating 1 or 2.
Foul was on Jones. Sutton converts the 3-point play, and Sean now with 13 points. Lyndon Jones with his first personal foul of this basketball game. And the Hoosiers now have dug themselves into the biggest hole of the ball game. They're down by 11. Here is Harmon trying to chop it to 9. Cannot. Fox on a great rebound. Can't get it. Harmon again and good. Harmon should get credit for the hoop, but a good follow-up.
That's what we have to do. We have to hit the offense. offensive board. We did not do that the first half.
Armand now with a half a dozen points in this ball game. He averaged over 30 points per game last year at Gary Wallace High School for head coach Earl Smith. There's a good strong baseline move by Desmond Porter. You know, Bill, they've gotten some good efforts out of guys that we didn't hear much of last week. Porter is one of those. He has 13 points in this contest so far.
Yes, Sutton, Feldhouse, Porter, Ware have played tremendously, and Pelphrey's played better than that.
Armand on a second effort after missing the first shot, went to the baseline, got the hoop. He has now equaled his entire point output in the first half, the first minute five of the second half. He has 8 points in this ballgame. Hoosiers down by 9, 66 to 57. They've been down by 11. The ball game was tied last at 40, and since then it's been all Kentucky. Here's Sutton again. Great defensive play by Fox. Into Sutton. He can't get it. Sean had it knocked away, picked out by Jones, and here come the Hoosiers. They want to pick up the tempo if they can, but Kentucky gets back in a hurry. Armand again, you betcha. He has all six of the Hoosiers' points of the second half, Bill.
The thing that we're seeing now is that Indiana is more aggressive defensively. They're hitting the offensive board, and they're moving the ball up and down the court. That's the way we have to play to win.
Out of bounds to Kentucky. First Indiana Boys All-Star team was named in 1939 and played an in-state game against the state champion Frankfort team. The Indiana-Kentucky series began in 1940 with the exception of the Warriors, World War II, 43 and 44. They have renewed that rivalry each June. And they finally went to two games in 1955. They played most of the games here in Louisville, some in Lexington. That just didn't work out too well either. And here is Lamont Ware getting a couple of points. More than 60 of these All-Star players over the years have gone on to pro basketball. As you can imagine, there have just been some sensational players. Here is Fox. Fox has got it. Now there's the ball down in low like you suggested, Joe. Rick Fox with 9.
You'll notice Fox and Harmon are getting the ball inside this half. Indiana has to get the ball inside if they're going to win, and that's what they started out doing. Coaches at the half did an excellent job in seeing what needed to be done to win the basketball game.
2.5 minutes into the second half with the Indiana Stars down by 7, 68-61, and Lyndon Jones knocks a couple of those off. He had only one field goal in the first half. He has 7 points so far in this ball game. Lyndon had 16 points and 5 boards in the victory last Saturday at Market Square Arena, in front of 14,000-plus. Indiana girls won their game tonight, 88-73. For a sweep. Here is Jones, and he got there in a hurry.
I think you'll notice that Edwards saw the play coming and got the block. A very intelligent play on his part.
And a timeout has been taken. You're watching the Indiana-Kentucky All-Star basketball game. Floor of the action.
I think they're playing more intensely. They're working real hard on defense, and I think right now Coleman has provided a little speed and quickness that was sorely needed.
And some pressure on the full-court defense also, but quickly the Kentucky Stars pick up two from Desmond Porter. Well, they broke that front line of the full-court pressure being used by Indiana and got two in a hurry. And they're back to a 5-point lead at 70-65 with 16 and a half minutes to play in this ball game. Here's Lyndon Jones. Partially blocked, I believe. Nope, apparently not. The Indiana Stars thought that perhaps at the moment Lamont Ware had touched it, but I guess not. So do the Indiana fans, by the way.
I think what they're really saying was that Jones got fouled on the shot.
Possibility there, too, I suppose. Sean Sutton dishes it off inside. Pelphrey left-hands it up there. Harmon's got it. He's got the outlet pass to Edwards. Here is Edwards going one-on-one on Sutton. Lost it away to Fox, and a whistle and a foul on Sean Sutton. Sutton with number one. Here it comes again. Bill Harrell takes a look at it.
Intimidation of Pelphrey. Good rebound there and a long pass out to Edwards taking it to basket. It was fouled by Sutton. Indiana's going to shoot two.
Now change. Pelphrey will come out. They'll reinsert Kevin Ellery. John Pelphrey going out of the game with 10 points, all scored in the first half. And Kevin Ellery, 29.7 score. At Washington County, headed for Notre Dame, comes into the ball game with he had 9 points last week. He had 4 in the first half this week. Here is Edwards. And Jay now with 20. can call it an all-star game if you want to, Bill, and indeed that's what it is because all these guys are all-stars, but you need that quarterback on the ball club like you've had over the years with the Bearcats. You still need a quarterback on an all-star squad.
That's exactly right. You have to have somebody out there that'll play the role of doing what needs to be done to win the ball game.
Foul call, baseline, Jerome Harmon, number one on him. Right now, Coleman is filling that bill for Indiana.
How would you like...
Is on Jerome Harmon,
yeah, that was a great penetration there, and even though Fox and Harmon were in there to make the block, they got him on the arm, and he gets two shots.
So here's Lamont Ware. Lamont now with 7 points in this basketball game. Ware, last week, 21 points, 11 rebounds. He had 8 out of 12 from the floor and 4 out of 5 from the free throw stripe, and he is headed for Austin Peay.
Austin Peay also has Desmond Porter, so you might say that Austin Peay, Lake Kelly, our coach there, has done an excellent job this year of recruiting.
The Indianapolis Star presented 4-92, and in reality, the game was never really that close, but Bill, it's been a complete turnaround tonight. Kentucky's been tough all the way.
Yeah, we're getting it inside to Fox a little now, though, and he made a good move then, but he missed his shot.
Couldn't get the rebound, chased down to the baseline by Coleman, and he may have stepped on the baseline. Indeed, he did. Oh, this Jerry Coleman on your screen right there is some kind of a basketball player. He was one of the reasons that Richmond went to that state championship battle last year and lost to the Marion Giants. Good score, but he is the quarterback of the ball club that was for George Griffith and is in this All-Star game.
Now, you notice that Indiana's going to half-court 1-3-1 trap, and Kentucky's attacking it very well. They got it inside and scored again.
That is Desmond Porter. He got the ball on the baseline. There wasn't anybody within 4 or 5 feet of him, and then took about one dribble and got the hoop. Now they're back to a 7-point lead again, 74-67. Harmon and Edwards. And Jay Edwards' first field goal, second half, he has 23. Indiana won the first three All-Star games with Kentucky, won 13 of the first 14. Kentucky has won 5 of the last 7, though. And Indiana leads the overall series 48-30. Well, Feldhaus continues to play like that. They may not add this game to the win column tonight.
The thing is happening to us now, Kentucky's penetrating the 1-3-1 trap real easy, and we have to do a better job with the 1-3-1 trap if we're going to stay in here.
Here is a technical foul on Fox for hanging onto the rim. Now, George Griffith comes off the bench across the way. He's not happy. Let's look at it again.
Edwards got the ball inside to Fox. He went in, missed the dunk, hung on the rim, and I think the reason he hung on the rim, a Kentucky player was under him, undercut him, and however, the referee didn't call that. He called the technical foul for hanging on the rim, and it was just a judgment call by the referee. That's the way he saw it.
Will get the technical foul shot. He has 15 points in this ball game, and now Kentucky will get the ball out of bounds, and that man is not a happy man, George Griffith. And he is one intense, outstanding basketball coach. Now it's 77-69 with 14:44 to play. There's a ton of time. But what bothers you if you're an Indiana fan a little bit is the fact that Indiana's not shown any great ability to sustain an effort, a long-term effort to get back into the ball game. Now they did, after trailing by 10, come back, and here's a foul from behind. It should be on Kentucky. Oh, wait a minute. It's going to be on Harmon, they say. Wow. That on Jerome Harmon is number 2. Let's take a look at this again and see if you can pick it out.
Well, Kentucky shot from the outside, and Indiana's blocking the outside. They went after the ball, and it looked like that call could have gone either way. Tough call. Well, especially for Indiana.
Yeah, with the other ways where it went, there is George Griffith, Larry Angle, Don Bates, whom you met at halftime. This game is starting to heat up a little bit here. 77-69, Indiana All-Stars recognizing that Kentucky came to play tonight. 14:20 to play in the game.
I think you'll see that Indiana now has dropped back into the more of a 2-3 variety defense, and I think they had to do that because Kentucky was just doing too good a job against the 1-3-1 track.
That foul is on Lamont Ware. I've got him for 4. And a good quick move by Jay Edwards. Sometimes Edwards makes those moves, Bill, and moves and finds himself in a position where he doesn't have much to do with the basketball. He almost got himself in that position that time.
Yeah, and that's really going to hurt the Kentucky chances because Ware is an excellent player, and his stats last week were outstanding. Jones can penetrate against most people.
Jones over the year was a 68% free throw shooter with the Giants at 6 out of 9 last week. Now he is 1 out of 2 in this half, 4 out of 6 in the ballgame. And they will take Desmond Porter out of the lineup. He has 3 personal fouls. Number 10 on your screen was Joey Couch with a 12.8 rebound per game average playing his high school ball at Paintsville. He also headed for the University of Kentucky but on a football scholarship. Oh, what a sensational defensive play turned in by Derrick Keyes. Here comes Indiana in a hurry. Edwards got it. Now we'll see if that fires him up a little bit. Edwards with 25 points now. Here's the full-court pressure. Here's the reach-in foul. It'll be on Lyndon Jones. Two on him. The fouls in the ballgame, not picking on the officials, but the fouls have slowed down a couple of opportunities for Indiana.
Well, the full-court pressure speeded up the game again, and they went from the half-court to the full-court, so I think Coach Griffith knows that he's going to have to stay after him hard because if he lets them do what they want to, well, then I think they're going to control us. But he's doing a great job with his pressure defense, full court, and Indiana's really working hard at the present time.
Marvin Meredith, the head coach of the Kentucky Stars, who was the head coach at Russell High School. Here's a foul being called against Indiana, and it's on number 10, Derrick Keith. He said, Bill Harrell, this was the shortest high school all-star team in the state of Kentucky in the last 20 years. And it's not a very large team. And to be quite honest, what I saw last Saturday at Market Square Arena, it was not a very good all-star team. But this team tonight is a whole lot better than what I saw last Saturday night.
Yeah, and it does make a difference when you get beat the first game. Then you think, well, we're going to play harder. We're representing our state, and we're going to give it a good go. And I think Kentucky's really giving it a good go tonight.
Massive changes. Coleman's the only one that stays in the ball game for Indiana. John Wilczynski is in there, picks off that rebound. Here is Barrett faking the three-pointer. Now back out to Coleman. Coleman's got great speed and quickness inside. Threw up a prayer. Here's Etherington. And Brett has his sixth point of this game. Brett with an 18.5 scoring average at Western High School for Tom Lewis, 6'7", 195 pounder.
This is a very important time of the basketball game. Indiana's resting its starters. They're down 3 at the present time. And I would say if this group can contain Kentucky for a couple of minutes, then it'll make quite a difference in the ball game.
Well, Donald Tevis almost walked with the ball, did not, controlled the dribble, has his fourth point of the contest. The lead goes back to 5 again. Be nice to see the subs come in and give you something other than just killing time for 2 or 3 minutes, and I'm sure that's what George Griffith is hoping for right now. Here is Lyndon, Jimmy Apple. Now the inside move to Barrett. Couldn't get the reverse, and Matthew Itudis picks up the rebound. 12:35 to play in this basketball game, with Kentucky wearing what would be normally the traveling road uniforms out in front as they have been throughout most of this contest. They add 2 more with a good outside shot by Matthew Itudis. Itudis played his high school ball at North Hardin. He's heading for Transylvania next year. A 7-point lead. It's been as high as 11 this half. Indiana led a couple of times late in that first half, or about halfway, I guess 3/4 of the way through it, but only by a couple of points. Now the lead pass up court. That'll reach of Joey Couch. We're at Freedom Hall in Louisville, Kentucky. Jerry Baker, along with Bill Harrell, the head basketball coach of the Bearcats of Muncie Central, who won 3 state championships, 2 at Muncie and 1 at Shelby County here in Kentucky, and coached these Stars a couple of years. And has a feel for just how difficult it is to convince these kids it's going to be tougher the second time around. Jimmy Apple gets his first 2 points of the ball game. Now only Eric Ewer, Kyle Persinger, and John Wilczynski have not scored in that 13-player roster for the Indiana Stars. 81-76, Indiana trails by 5 with 11 and a half minutes to go in this game.
Hey, This is exactly what Indiana wants. Kentucky slowed the game down now, the slowest pace they've had, and they have the Indiana substitutes in the game at this time, and Tennis got away with the walk. But Indiana got the rebound, and they can cut it back to three.
While Wilczynski tipped it, Etherington got the rebound. Here is the underneath pass intercepted that time by Kevin Ellery. Here's the lead pass to Donald Tivis. What you're saying right now, Bill, is that the Indiana Stars don't care so much if they score. They want to keep the other team from scoring for a couple of minutes.
That's right, and the turnover really hurt because it went, instead of being down three, they're down seven.
All right, 83-76 your score, 10:40 to play in this basketball game. Ball game was last tied at 40, and from that point on, it's been all Kentucky. Here's the three by Dave Barrett. That is only the second three-pointer in this ball game for Indiana. Edwards had one, now Barrett has the other. Kentucky used the three-pointer very effectively in the first half. Here is the walk by Matthew Itoudis. They had six three-pointers in the first half. Did Kentucky, they have not hit any, though, in the second half of play. And with 10:19 to play in this ballgame, it's 83-79. Pretty important possession right here, as you talked about a while ago, to get that thing down within a couple.
Now, this group has really played fine basketball. They're handling the ball well. They're playing together as a unit. They're running the offense, moving the ball around, and Etherington takes a good shot inside. Missed it, but they did have a good shot.
Had a good defensive play turned in by Dave Barrett. Now it is three on three. Here is Barrett, the three-pointer. Rebounded by Kentucky. Now the Kentuckians have a three-on-two advantage. They've got it down low, and they got the two from Kevin Ellery. Boy, just like that, Bill, we turn it from a potential two-point deficit to a six-point deficit.
Yeah, I didn't like that shot. I think at that time they need to move the ball and get a good shot and penetrate with the ball instead of a quick shot and giving Kentucky an opportunity to fast break.
Yeah, we'll see how much longer George Griffith goes with the group on the floor. Here's the three-pointer outside, and that is Jimmy Apple. Apple gets his first three-pointer of the ball game. Now Indiana has 5 points out of Apple, and the lead is chopped to three.
Apple can make a great contribution in this game because he is a pure shooter, and he can get the outside shot. And when you're behind, it helps to get those three-pointers.
He is the only All-Star, am I correct, from south of Indianapolis. He's from Salem, played for Jerry Warner down there, going to William & Mary. Here is the steal by Barrett. Here's the lead to Coleman. Watch this. You put Coleman one-on-one with anybody his size, and he's going to take him right to the hole. Now the lead is chopped to one, so they've come back from an 11-point deficit here in the second half to get it to one. And they've done it with that, you say, substitute. That's pretty hard to say when you got five All-Stars out there.
They're doing a great job. They just weren't the starters, but they're playing like they could be starters.
Etherington's got the board. Flips it off on the far side to Barrett. They've got Apple open on the near side. Barrett takes it all the way inside. Here is Apple, little 10-footer. Yes, sir. Jimmy Apple has 7 points that come off the bench, and this was the time-killing squad, Coach, and they've taken the lead out there.
Yeah, I tell you what, I watched Apple shoot this morning. Great shooter.
Timeout has been taken. You're watching the Indiana-Kentucky All-Star basketball game. The Indiana All-Stars have grabbed that lead over Kentucky 86-85. And that's a little happier place to be right now because of the score on your screen, 86-85 Indiana. And Jimmy Apple's done a lot of that.
He's a great outside shooter.
Apple out of Salem High School, heading for William & Mary, had no points, took only one field goal shot in that game last Saturday, came away with one rebound, did not shoot a free throw, and Apple now has 7 points on three field goals, one of those a three-pointer. And they've all come here in the second half where that relief unit was in there, so to speak. Here is Jones with a reach-in personal foul, number three on him. That's got to be a lift for your ball, but whether you're Indiana or Kentucky, you're sitting over there saying, well, those guys aren't getting it done, let's get them out, give them a blow, and put in this other unit, and that unit goes in and gets you the lead.
And I think the thing, Jerry, these guys are All-Stars, too, and they want everybody to know they are. And they're certainly playing like All-Stars. And, you notice they're still in there, too.
You know, there's a little bit of competitiveness going on here. You can only start five guys. So when you take them out, those other, well, in this case, the other eight guys saying, I'm as good as they are. They can't wait to get in there and show that they deserve to be on this All-Star squad. So it's an interesting little bit of intra-squad play, if you will. Here is Barrett. He's had a big factor in this game. Here's Apple again. Oh, rims it, comes out of there. Rebound yanked off by Desmond Porter. Here comes Kentucky Pelphrey now. Mr. Basketball is back in that lineup for the All-Stars. Here is Sean Sutton dishing down low. And on the floor, Hell Ball. Arrow pointing toward Indiana. So the Hoosiers will get it.
if that ball had gone in at apple shot there, you know, and it went round and round.
Could have been a big one.
Yes, sir. I think they need to keep going to him, too.
You saw a good tight shot of George Griffith. Typical of those North Central Conference coaches pacing the sideline, pulling their hair out. Doesn't he know this is an exhibition?
We don't get a pace much anymore, Jerry.
No, you don't. That's come to think of it. You're right. I won't even ask you what you think of that. I've seen you coach too many times. Here is Dave Barrett. He has 7 points, five in this half, and one of those a three-point field goal. Indiana's got its biggest lead of the ball game by three. They led early in this contest by two. I shouldn't say early, about three-fourths of the way through the first half. They led for a couple of occasions and have trailed ever since, as many as 11 points down a couple of times. This shot, follow-up rebound, good effort by Kevin Ellery. Ellery gets the field goal. He has 8 points, and Bill, they just kind of backed out of there. We'll look at it again. They just backed out and gave him all the room he wanted under there.
I think what happened, some way Coleman got switched on to Ellery, and of course, that's quite a mismatch.
All right, there's Apple. The foul was on Jimmy Apple. I've got him for number one, and Kevin Ellery is at that free throw stripe. Well, he is a good-looking guy. Kevin Ellery is 6'5", 230 pounds, heading for Notre Dame. Ellery now with 9 points in the game. And we're tied at 88. That's the sixth time the ball game has been tied. The last tie was back at 40. Porter on the rebound for Kentucky. Clock showing 6 minutes and 40 seconds to play with Indiana and Kentucky knotted at 88. And Kentucky has the basketball. Pelphrey had the baseline shut off beautifully by John Wilczynski. Here's the three, and long rebound picked out of there by Sean Sutton. Here is Ellery with the board, taken away underneath. I'll tell you right now, Kentucky owns the board for this span of time, Bill.
We've got to do a better job on the defensive board. Of course, as you can see, we do have a relatively small lineup in there. And Kentucky has some pretty good height in Pelphrey and Feldhaus and Ellery.
And the bucket's going to count. Coleman picks up the foul. John Pelphrey had the ball actually knocked away. Look at this again and watch him maintain control and get the shot away.
Yeah, you see Pelphrey making a good move. He gets hit on the arm as he goes up, loses the ball a little, then regains it and shoots it and scores, and the foul's called.
John Pelphrey with a total of 12 points to his credit, now 13.
That's two straight three-point plays.
Pelphrey at the Paintsville High School that he attended averaged 20.2. He had only 3 points in that ball game last Saturday. He has come back with 13 in tonight's contest, and proven maybe he does deserve that tag of being Mr. Basketball. We got massive changes for Indiana just seconds from now. Brett Etherington moves the ball inside, and here's a walking violation being called on John Wilczynski. Now here come the changes. Jones is coming back into the lineup. Gary Keyes will be in there. Edwards is in there.
I think you'll see that they did, the score's the same. They're only down three. So they didn't lose a thing. They played excellent basketball and actually had a three-point lead until Kentucky got those two straight three-point plays.
Fox has come back in the lineup now for Indiana. And Jerome Harmon is also in the ballgame. Well, here comes the pressure from everywhere. We're inside 6 minutes, 5 minutes and 52 seconds to play in this contest. Kentucky has really been a much better ball club tonight than they were last week. They lobbed it inside over Fox, going back into Jay Edwards. Now here come the Hoosiers, trailing by three. Here is Fox. Fox had it so easy, I'm sure he couldn't believe he missed that shot. Sutton comes near side to Porter. Porter goes down to the baseline and got the shot away and scored. I'll tell you what, Desmond Porter can flat play this basketball game. He is out of Pleasure Ridge Park, which is not too far from here. He's heading for Cleveland State. They're going to love him at Cleveland State. Here's coaching.
Yeah.
I think he probably is.
Yes, sir. He's working hard.
He is getting into the basketball game, and best he does, because his ball club is down by five with 5 minutes and 10 seconds to play. Edwards inside the Fox, couldn't hold on to it, and it belongs to Kentucky. Well, Kentucky swept both games last year in the sweeps division. Indiana has 11 sweeps, Kentucky 8, including the pair last year. Here is Sutton. Oh, you can't give him that kind of room. This kid can play. Sutton with 15 points. Here is a foul called on Sean Sutton, number two on him. There's been a lot of pressure on somebody like Eddie Sutton when you're at a school like Kentucky, Bill, where they think it's a religion over there, and you recruit your son.
Well, you can see why they recruited him, because he is a great player, but I agree with you. It's hard to coach your son regardless where you are.
4 minutes and 55 seconds of playing time. A 95-88 basketball game with Kentucky out in front by seven. Indiana had tied the ball game at 88, so the boys in the Bluegrass State have run off seven successive points, and that's kind of been one of the stories of this ball game. Edwards with three, rims out of there, and Harmon bangs it home. With 8 points in the second half, as a dozen on the night. He averaged 30.1 over the year. At Gary Wallace for Earl Smith. Well, the penetration inside, that time by Feldhaus, has been another key to this basketball game. Our inside defense has not been real good tonight.
Yeah, he made an excellent move that time. He got the jump step in there, and Edwards came back and made a real good move, too. So it's really heating up right now. Things are happening real quick.
5 to 4 minutes and 8 seconds to play in this basketball game. The Kentucky All-Stars have obviously put in a pretty strong week of practice under their head coach Marvin Meredith and Charles Baker out of East Carter, their assistant. Now, they have put on quite a show tonight. Dodgers a 3-on-1 advantage. Here is Harmon. He's got it. Jerome Harmon. Now a 14. 10 of which have come in the second half. Now the leaders chop the three again with 3:45 to play. Foul called prior to the shot against Indiana. Now, I think the Hoosiers might have been a little slow just getting back on defense then, and a slap, kind of a slap steal at the mid-court stripe, and suddenly they're outnumbered at the other end.
Yeah, I think that in that particular play, the defensive player, had he just moved his feet instead of trying to steal the ball, he might have been able to draw a charge at that point. But Kentucky's handling the pressure, but I think it's working in Indiana's favor because they do have it cut to three again.
The only thing that's not working in our favor is that doggone clock up there as far as Indiana's concerned, because about the time the Hoosiers get back into the ball game, Kentucky comes storming back and runs off a string of points. They have not let Indiana get anything going for any consistent span of time. Here's the three. It is good. And it's Edwards. Edwards has his second three-pointer of this ball game, and Edwards is the leading scorer. Now with 30 points. Jay had 21, making 18 points last Saturday in that victory. But here's Kentucky again getting back in a hurry. Here is Porter. No good. Rebound comes off to Indiana's Jerome Harmon. High ball game at 97. Harmon's got 10 rebounds, and the Hoosiers have the lead. That is Jones with a dozen points.
Remember, we said before the game that they were going to have to defend Fox tonight, which they have done. But as we said, Edwards has had a lot more freedom, and that shows up in his 30 points.
It's exactly what you said might happen for the ball game, Bill. If you cover Fox, somebody else is going to be free in there. Fox has 9 points in this ball game tonight. Edwards, unofficially on my score sheet, has 30. And that has been, he's picked up the scoring slack. Now, Jones had only a 5-point first half, but he's picked up 7 in the second half. They got a good, strong second half from Jerome Harmon, and let's not forget that strong effort by Jimmy Apple and Dave Barrett during that span of time that they played also.
The great competitors. That does make a difference.
Sean missed the free throw, something he's not prone to do. He's an excellent free throw shooter. Now Indiana with a 2-point lead. Their biggest lead has been 3. Their biggest deficit has been 11. They could get their biggest lead of the game right here. 2 minutes and 42 seconds to play. Inside to Rick Fox. Fox has missed about 3 shots from right there. Here's Sean Sutton. Here's the lead pass. And a great defensive play by Jones, but a foul on Lyndon. And that is the 4th on him.
All right, that's the thing. Fox hadn't gotten the ball as much as he'd like to tonight. And when he does get it, he's missing his short shot.
Well, Pelphrey tore that rebound out of there and got it up court in a hurry.
A great effort by Jones there on the block.
Lamont Ware will be at the free throw stripe. Barrett has come back into the ball game. Coleman is in there now. Jones is in the lineup. Jerome Harmon is in there. Rick Fox is in the lineup. For Kentucky, they've got number 6, Lamont Ware, at the free throw stripe. Ernest Rakes for Kentucky is now in the lineup. He is number 4. Rakes, I think, maybe for his first time of the game. He's out of Boyd County heading for Kentucky Wesleyan. Darren Feldhaus is in the lineup. Sean Sutton is in the ball game. We're going down to the wire with 2.5 minutes to play. That's the coaching staff of the Kentucky Stars. Ware has 9 points. His average is 17.9 over the season haul. A one-point lead. This has been some kind of a basketball game tonight.
I was going to say, Jerry, where can you see better basketball than this?
Harmon. Well, Harmon and Edwards have taken over things, mainly Harmon in this second half of this basketball game. He's got 6 field goals for 16 points total. Oh, my. Wild collision down in front of the Kentucky bench. A good head fake that time by Ernest Rakes. He got Barrett in the air. Take a look at this again. Fortunately, nobody got hurt.
Rakes did a good job of getting Barrett up in the air, and he rode him without a saddle.
They're both up, and they're all right. Just a good, strong defensive effort and a nice offensive effort turned out at the same time.
And line, Ernest Rakes.
So Rakes goes to the free throw stripe.
And he'll have two.
He'll get a couple of shots. We mentioned Rakes out of Boyd County, 6'2", 170-pounder, averaged 18 points a game. He's an 85% free throw shooter, and he missed the first one. Got the second one. And it's a 101-99 basketball game. Indiana with a two-point lead with 2:05 to play. Now Kentucky picks up that pressure a little further up court. Coleman breaks it, gets the ball to Edwards. Edwards will take a rather unadvised shot, and rebound taken off by Kentucky's Desmond Porter. Lead pass near side, Lamont Ware. He is tough. We will have goaltending turned in against Eric Harmon. Or Eric Harmon, Jerome Harmon. We will take a look at it again here.
Well, Ware is penetrating to the basket, and the ball got to the board, and they blocked it off the board, and goaltending.
Here comes Indiana back at the other end, and Harmon knocks it home. Boy, Harmon's having some kind of a second half. It's a 103-101 ball game with a foul being called now on Harmon. You heard Jim Paulowski at halftime suggesting that next year the games will also be Indiana first and Kentucky second, Louisville second, because of a scheduling conflict here at Freedom Hall. So don't be disappointed next year when they start talking about the game of the Indianapolis Star and naming the team. Make sure you get your tickets and get on down to Market Square Arena. Sutton has missed two in a row. And that is unlike Sean Sutton, who was a 76% free throw shooter. He did not go to the line at all in that game last Saturday. Sutton with 16, including a three-pointer. Now the pressure. And it's a 103-102 basketball game with a minute 25 to play here at Freedom Hall in Louisville. Lamont Ware on the rebound after Harmon missed it. Down to a minute and 10 seconds to go. We got a 45-second shot clock in the high school game tonight, so Indiana will certainly get at least one more possession. Here's the loose ball. It is picked up by Indiana. If it's a hell ball, it'll belong to Kentucky. It'll belong to Kentucky anyway. Well, nobody can find the handle on that thing.
You always heard the way the ball bounces makes a lot of difference in a ball game. There, Indiana had a player out open in the court. We just couldn't pick it up. We'd have had a three-point lead instead of Kentucky having the ball, being able to maybe go in the lead by one or two, according to what they do.
Final 59 seconds of the game. Sutton comes off near side. Here is Ware, missing. Rebounded by Indiana. The Hoosiers have a 103-103 ball game at their beck and call. Here is Harmon turning, firing, can't get it. Rebound to Pelphrey and a foul on Harmon. Jerome's third foul.
Now, Harmon made a great move inside to get the shot. Missed it, then went over the back and fouled Pelphrey. And now Kentucky's going to the line for 1-1.
All right, now they put the score back to where it was. I thought it was 103-102, and suddenly they popped up a 103-103 over there. It is 103-102, Indiana out in front by one. The only, if it's a negative, Bill, the last couple of times up, we've taken some all-star-type shots. We have not... Indiana has not worked the ball like you might expect them to do under those kind of situations. Pelphrey can give it Kentucky a lead here. He's got the high. He is 6 out of 8 from the free throw stripe tonight, John Pelphrey. And he has 14 points in the ball game. And Fox has got the rebound. We are tied at 103.
You know, we got 42 seconds on the clock with 48 seconds to go in the game.
Now, what are you going to take? You going to take one, coach? What are you going to do?
I'm going to work for a real good one. I don't know what they'll do, but just make sure I get a real good shot.
Take it when it becomes available. In other words, don't wait for the final 5 seconds, but if you get one earlier than that, go ahead and take it.
Yeah, I think there's going to be about 5 or 6 seconds left after Indiana takes a shot. There's 8 seconds difference, I think.
The Hoosiers have trailed by as many as 11. The biggest lead they've had in the entire game has been 3, and they had to really fight hard to get that because Kentucky has flat played a much better basketball game tonight than they did a week ago. Barrett takes it. He's got it. Barrett didn't really want it. He was looking for somebody else. Now Kentucky will take the timeout. You're watching the Indiana-Kentucky All-Star Basketball Game. The Indiana All-Stars lead Kentucky by 2, 105-103.
Now, immediately following this game, for the presentation of those valuable player awards, one to the Kentucky player.
Here Barrett is, and he's looking for somebody to pass it to. Nobody's open. He says, I can hit it, and he pops it in.
He did that for Steve Bennett at Lafayette Catholic throughout the year. They had a great season up there. He averaged 18-1. He was a 56% field goal shooter.
You'd have to say that's great that George Griffith had him in there at that time, wouldn't you?
Good coaching.
That's
good coaching.
That's
now,
right.
Let's see what the Kentucky Stars can do. They've got 9 seconds to come up court and get off a good shot and tie or win this basketball game. There's the magic of the three-point field goal shot in the high school ranks. Now they're not playing necessarily, or they don't have to play for a tie-up. They've got the courage of their convictions, but I'll guarantee they'd settle for it right now.
Indiana's going to full court press, and they got Fox back to protect the basket. They're going to really try to make Kentucky turn it over, and they had him on the side.
Here is Sutton. Penetration. It is up. It is no good. The tap up is good. Does it count? Yes. Lamont Ware will get the tap in, I believe. Yeah, it counts. There's still 2 seconds on the scoreboard clock. It took forever for those 9 seconds to tip off. Timeout has been taken by Indiana with 3 seconds to go now. You're watching the Indiana-Kentucky All-Star Basketball Game. 3 seconds left, tie ball game at 105. Kentucky credit, Bill Harrell. They got the ball in. They met the pressure. They got the ball up court, and they got a good shot away. Here comes that last shot.
Yeah, Sutton penetrated all the way to the basket, missed the shot, but there was that man Ware again. He went up, got the rebound, put it in, and we have a tie ball game with 3 seconds to go.
Well, I'll tell you, Lamont Ware is some kind of a basketball player, not just from scoring, but just getting the job done. Now, here comes the final play. Barrett inbounds to Edwards, 3 seconds, 2. It's good if it goes. Any hit the rim and just missed it.
Oh, it was a great effort.
Oh, Edwards had it right on target. So we're going to go overtime. This has been one of the strangest All-Star games, Bill, I've ever seen. Early on, Kentucky gets a lead. They stretch it out to 10 points in the first 10 minutes of the ball game or so. And finally, Indiana ties it at 23. We're tied at 23, 25, 32, 34, 40, and then the roof caves in for Indiana, and Kentucky runs off to a 61-53 lead. They come out, stretch the lead to 11 in the second half. Then the next thing you know, we're tied at 88. And then old Mo swings the other way, and the Hoosiers have it. 2-point lead, 9 seconds to go, and now we go to overtime. Good Lord, this is like a serial of some sort. Here is the last shot now. Watch it again by Jay Edwards. This is a pretty good shot, Coach.
Yeah, he really had a good shot. Went up right at the mid-stripe line and held himself in the air and had it on target just about a half an inch short.
Well, he had it right on the money. Well, we're at Freedom Hall in Louisville, Kentucky. Jerry Baker along with Muncie Central head coach Bill Harrell, and we have seen ourselves 40 minutes of exciting basketball. Not always well played, but always exciting tonight anyway.
Yeah, I think you have to point up the fact that the bench came in and really did a good job for Indiana tonight when they're in trouble.
Indeed. And Kentucky has also used its bench tonight, perhaps not to the degree that Indiana has because of the different circumstances whereby they have been leaders throughout much of this ball game this evening.
Yeah, it does make a difference what the score is, how you play the game.
Well, we go to overtime. We'll play 5 minutes here at Freedom Hall. The tip controlled by Indiana. Jay Edwards, who almost brought the game to a screeching halt with that shot from about 30 feet out. Fox threw it away, but last touch by Kentucky and chased down by Harmon. Rick Fox has only 2 points in the second half. Coleman. Here's Edwards, and he walked. Sure as the world. Girls High School All-Stars winners tonight, 88-73, and they were impressive. They got 21 points out of Dana Wilkerson tonight, 16 from Lori Meinerding, 15 from Chrissy Davis of Noblesville. And this could be the first time in the history of this game that either school has, that Indiana, I should say, has swept both games. Coleman, tough from right in there. Missed it this time, though, on a blocking foul that will be called on John Pelphrey.
Now there's Edwards again all over the floor. Got the loose ball over there and got her down. Coleman did a great job taking the ball to the basket and drew the foul, and he's going to be at the line for two shots that we sorely need at this point.
You're looking at Pelphrey on your screen. Sutton, by the way, has been playing this ball game with a slightly sprained ankle. It's not really had that big an impact on him, but he has had a little ankle problem. Here is Coleman with his seventh point of the night. Jerry averaged 17-9 for George Griffith at Richmond. A couple of big free throws now as Coleman has points number 7 and 8. 107-105. Indiana by 2. We're in overtime with 4:18 to play in this basketball game. Here's Desmond Porter. Boy, this guy's had a good night. Lamont Ware and Sean Sutton. Well, he's out along the professional three-point line now. Now here's Ware on the other side. Lamont Ware. Well, Bill, he does a good job sliding from one side of the floor to the other.
Well, he's really a great player. I'm very impressed with him.
Going to Austin Peay. Here's a good strip steal by Sutton and a layup by Sean. Sutton's got that elusive quality of quickness to go along with just speed. 6'1", 175-pounder out of Lexington, Henry Clay, heading for the Wildcat territory in Lexington next year.
Now, his daddy's known for those great defensive guards. Some of them playing in the pros at the time, so I see he probably taught his son real well.
Here's Edwards missing from three-point range, and Kentucky's got the rebound, and you got it. Lamont Weir comes out of there with it. As